Hello learners, I am Dr. Priyanka Gautam, welcoming you at NIOS. Today we are here to discuss the Senior Secondary Biology course, and today we are going to discuss on a topic, the coordination through hormones, the endocrine system. So learners, as we know that there are the communication systems, and on the communication system there are the two major communication systems that we know is the nervous system and endocrine system. So these are the two major system of communication and regulate throughout the body. So the endocrine system is the system of the two system that communication and regulation through the body, and hormones secreted by the endocrine cells regulate reproduction, development, energy metabolism, growth and behavior. So the number of the processes are being regulated by the secretion of the endocrine system that is called as the hormone. So another system of the communication is the nervous system. It is a network of specialized cells, neurons that transmit the signal along the dedicated pathway. So these signals in turn regulate the neurons, muscle cell, endocrine cell, because signaling by the neuron can also regulate the release of hormones. The neuron and endocrine system both overlap in their function. So first we will go through learners to the endocrine system. So endocrine system, that definitely it is containing the number of glands and their hormones. So two kind of glands are being incorporated into the endocrine system. The first one is the exocrine gland. The second one is the endocrine glands. There is a basic difference between the exocrine gland and endocrine gland. Exocrine glands, they release their secretion into the duct or the tubes, while the endocrine glands, they are called ductless gland. For example, like the liver, it is an exocrine gland. It secretes bile. That bile is released into the gallbladder, then through a duct into the small intestine. Like in the pancreas, they release the pancreatic juice into the small intestine through a duct. So these are the exocrine gland that is secreting their secretion, that is the hormone, through a duct. Then the second one, that is endocrine glands, they are called ductless gland. They release their hormone or the secretion directly into the bloodstream, and blood transport these hormones throughout the body. And each hormone act on a certain kind of tissue that is called the target tissue. So in the endocrine glands, they secrete their hormone not through the duct but directly into the bloodstream, and from there it is directly reaching to its target tissue. So the function of the endocrine system is to secrete the hormone into the bloodstream. So now we should know that what is hormone, how can we define the hormone. A hormone is a chemical messenger which target a specific group of cells in order to cause that group of cells to do some activities or to stop these activities by the mechanism of action. Then what is the nature of hormone? Nature and the function of hormone. So hormone, they are secreted from their source directly in the blood, and blood carry these hormones to the target cell which respond to it, and hormone regulate the physiological processes as well. They are produced in a very small quantity, and by the small quantity they can regulate a great reaction. So they are biologically very active even they are present in a very small quantity. Like if we take an example of the adrenaline, it is active even at a concentration of 1 in 300 million parts. So these are the nature and the function of the hormone. Then if we talk about the, because hormone are the secretion, and through the secretion there is a communication system. There are the number of communication system or signaling system that can function. So these system may include like the endocrine signaling, paracrine signaling, autocrine signaling, synaptic and neuroendocrine signaling, signaling by the pheromones. So we will go one by one to all of these learners. So first one is the endocrine signaling. What is endocrine signaling? In the endocrine signaling, secreted molecule diffuse into the blood stream and trigger the response in the target cell wherever the target cell is present. So, the target cell wherever it is present, hormone will affect directly to that target organ. The second one is the paracrine signaling. In the paracrine signaling, secreted molecule diffuse locally and trigger a response to a neighboring cell. So, not wherever present the body, but it is affecting only the neighboring cells. The third one is the autocrine signaling. In the autocrine signaling, secreted molecule diffuse locally and trigger a response in the cell that secrete them. So, definitely it is affecting the organ that directly affecting the secreted cells or the secreted body. Then third one is the next, the next one is the synaptic signaling. In the synaptic signaling, neurotransmitter diffuse across the synapse and trigger response in the cell of target tissue. The target tissue may be the neuron, muscles or the gland. So, here in the synaptic signaling, neurotransmitters are involved for this kind of signaling. Next is the neuroendocrine signaling. So, definitely it is including the neuro as well as the endocrine system. So, in the neuroendocrine signaling, the neurohormone diffuse into the, neurohormone diffuse into the bloodstream and trigger response in target cell wherever is present into the body. The one important type of signaling is the signaling by the pheromones. So, in the previous signaling method, these are the methods in which the signaling molecule is being secreted inside the body. But there are some communication method in which the molecule is released into the external environment. Of this, the example is the signaling by the pheromones, and the most important example of this is the Asian army ants. They use their lowered antennae, and by this they follow the pheromone marked trail as they carry pupae and larvae to their nest site. So, these are the different kinds of the signaling through which the signaling molecule transmit their signals. Now, learners, let me go to the various endocrine glands and their hormones that is being secreted into the body. So, in the endocrine glands, there are the number of endocrine glands those are present into the body that may include like hypothalamus, pineal gland, pituitary gland, thyroid gland, adrenal cortex, pancreas, ovary and the testes. And these are the number of the glands, endocrine and exocrine glands, as well as these all glands are also being connected to the number of the organs like the thymus, heart, liver, stomach, kidney and small intestine. So, we will go one by one to all the hormones and their endocrine glands. What are the endocrine glands and what hormone they are secreting and what is its function? So, first one is we will go through the hypothalamus and the pituitary that are the center of endocrine regulation. So, hypothalamus and pituitary, these both are the very important glands and their secretion are also important. Like in vertebrate, hypothalamus play a secondary role in integrating the endocrine as well as nervous system. So, it is controlling both endocrine as well as the nervous system. So, one of the several endocrine glands, those are located in the brain, the hypothalamus receive information from nerve throughout the body and include the brain, it also includes the brain, and in response the hypothalamus initiate a endocrine signaling appropriate to the environmental condition. Then these signal from the hypothalamus, it travels to the pituitary gland. So, what is pituitary gland? This pituitary gland is located at the base of the hypothalamus, and the pituitary gland is the very short gland. It is the size of lima bean, and it is divided into the two part, or it has the two part, that is posterior and the anterior lobe. So, they secrete different set of the hormones. So, both anterior pituitary as well as the posterior pituitary both secrete different hormones. The posterior pituitary is the extension of the hypothalamus, and hypothalamic axons that reaches into the posterior pituitary secrete the neurohormones that is synthesized in the hypothalamus. On the other way, if we talk about the anterior pituitary, it is an endocrine gland that synthesizes and secretes hormones in response to signal from the hypothalamus. So, one is controlling through the nervous and one is controlling through the endocrine glands. So, many anterior pituitary hormones act as a trophic hormone. So, what is trophic hormone, learners? Trophic hormones means those are that regulate the function of other endocrine cells or the glands too. So, those are the trophic hormones. So, the anterior pituitary hormones, they are include as the trophic hormones. So, this is the posterior pituitary. So, posterior pituitary is causing the secretion of the major two hormones, that is the ADH and the oxytocin. So, two hormones released from the posterior pituitary act directly onto the endocrine tissue, and oxytocin induces the uterine contraction and release of the milk from the mammary glands. And antidiuretic hormone ADH, it enhances the water reabsorption in the kidney. So, the release of the hormone synthesized in the anterior pituitary gland is controlled by the hypothalamus releasing an inhibitory hormones. The hypothalamus hormones are secreted by the neurosecretory cells and enter the capillary network within the hypothalamus. So, these capillary drain into the portal vein that connect with the secondary capillary network in the anterior pituitary. So, they both are connected. So, next one is the anterior pituitary. You can see here that anterior pituitary is secreting the number of the hormones, approximately like it is about the 6 hormones, and the anterior pituitary hormone can be differentiated into the 3 level, that is the trophic level, non-trophic level, and that is including the non-trophic and the trophic. So, you know now the what is the trophic hormones. So, the anterior pituitary, it is containing the number of hormones, and hormones sometimes acquire distinct role in different species over the course of evolution. Like the prolactin. Prolactin stimulates the milk production in the mammals but has the diverse effect in the different vertebrates. The another hormone like the melanocyte stimulating hormone MSH, it influences skin pigmentation in some vertebrates and fat metabolism in the mammals. So, they have the different role according to the species also. So, although the prolactin and MSH act on non-endocrine targets, and most anterior pituitary hormone are trophic and acting on the endocrine tissue or gland to regulate the hormone secretion. Then trophic hormones of the anterior pituitary, it include like TSH, FSH, LH and ACTH, and growth hormone has both trophic and the non-trophic effect. It produces growth directly and has diverse metabolic effect and stimulate the production of growth factors by the other tissue. So, what happens if there is something happen with the growth hormone? So, over secretion of the growth hormone, it causes the giantism in the childhood and also cause the, it may be into the adults too, and under secretion of the growth hormone, it causes dwarfism in the childhood. So, the growth hormone greatly affect the animals. The next hormone and its gland is the thyroid hormone. Thyroid is located in the neck area and it releases the two hormones, that is called the thyroxine and calcitonin. So, thyroid is, it is the thyroid regulation that is controlled by a cascade pathway. As like anterior pituitary hormone, it act in a cascade. In the case of the thyrotropin and thyroid stimulating hormone, it is regulated by the thyrotropin releasing hormone TRH, and TSH in turn induces the thyroid gland. So, then thyroid gland causes the secretion of the two thyroid hormone, thyroxine and calcitonin. So, what is the function of thyroxine? Thyroxine regulates the basal metabolism, that is the rate of the cellular oxidation resulting in the heat production, and control the growth and development of body temperature is also controlled and mental development as well. So, there are number of functions that has been controlled by the thyroid hormone thyroxine. The next, that is the calcitonin. So calcitonin regulate the calcium and phosphate level in the blood. If the calcium level in the blood is high, more calcitonin is secreted and the calcium ions are moved from the blood to the bones, so making the bones harder. And in the other condition, when the reverse happens, when the calcium level and the blood is low, it makes the bone soft. So in both case, the calcium level is maintained by this calcitonin hormones. So in hormones and the other mammals, thyroid hormone regulate the bioenergetics, so help maintaining normal blood pressure, heart rate, muscle tone, and regulate the digestive as well as the reproductive functions. And the production of the hormone is also cause the various disease, like over secretion of the thyroxine, it causes the nervousness and the weight loss, and under secretion of the thyroxine result into the cretinism, that is the mental retardation. So here is the thyroid gland that is causing the change into the neck portion. So iodine deficiency in your diet, it may cause the goiter disease. So these are the two figures that is showing the goiter into the individual. The next is the parathyroid hormone. The parathyroid hormone and the vitamin D control the blood calcium level. So located in the back of the thyroid, these parathyroid are present just back side of the thyroid gland, and these are hormone that secreting the parathormone, and under secretion of the parathormone result in the nerve disorder, and it also brittle the bone and clotting problems. So function of the is it control the metabolism of the calcium. And parathyroid hormone, that is it is regulating the blood calcium. When it is blood calcium level fall down at a set point about the 10 mg per 100 ml, these glands release parathyroid hormone, and the function is that is metabolism of the calcium. And this is the how it regulate the calcium level in the mammals. When there is a low concentration of the blood calcium, that is the set point, that is the 10 mg per 100 ml, then parathyroid hormone stimulate the calcium ion uptake from the kidney as well as from the intestine, and you can see here also from the bones. So after that intake, it is increasing the blood calcium level. So this is cycle, that when the blood calcium level is reduced, and if it is high, the cycle is reversed. So both condition, the calcium is being controlled by the parathyroid hormone. The next hormone or the gland is the adrenal gland and the adrenal hormone. So adrenal gland of vertebrate are associated with the kidney, the renal organ. In mammals, there are the two types. Adrenal glands can be, it is of made up of two regions, the adrenal cortex and the adrenal medulla. The adrenal medulla is of the nerve origin, while the adrenal cortex is the endocrine origin. So these are the cells, these are like the pituitary gland, and each gland is fused from the endocrine and the neuroendocrine glands. So next gland is the adrenal gland. Adrenal gland, it is of the vertebrate and it is associated with the kidney. And in mammals, the adrenal gland is actually made up of two types, that is the adrenal cortex and the adrenal medulla. The adrenal cortex consists of the endocrine cells, where the secretory cell of the adrenal medulla derived from the neural tissue during its embryonic development. So one is the endocrine origin, other is the neural in origin. So thus, like the pituitary gland, each adrenal gland is a fused endocrine and the neuroendocrine glands. So both, this is the fusion of both kind of gland. It is located into the kidney, and it is secreting the hormone, that is cortisone and adrenaline. The function of the cortisone is regulate the carbohydrate, protein and the fat metabolism, while the adrenaline is to raise the blood sugar level and increase the heartbeat and the breathing rate. This is the adrenal gland. It is containing the two part, adrenal cortex as well as the adrenal medulla. So, adrenal, what happened when there is the under secretion of the adrenaline? So, adrenaline, that is, if there is less secretion, definitely you are unable to deal with the stress condition. So, if you have the more workload, then you are not able to perform well due to the under secretion of the adrenaline hormone. Next gland is the thymus. The thymus, this is located at the base of the neck, and it produces some hormones that is involved in the maturation of T lymphocyte, and it begins to atrophy after puberty. The next is the placenta. The placenta of the pregnant women produces certain hormones, like the most important is the human chorionic gonadotropin, which maintain the activity of the corpus luteum in secreting progesterone continuously when a woman becomes pregnant. So, it is definitely helping into the this particular condition. The hormone, the next is, that is the hormone from the stomach and the intestine. Basically, it is secreting the three kind of hormones, the gestrin, secretin and cholecystokinin. Gestrin is a hormone secreted by mucous membrane of the pyloric end of the stomach, and it stimulates the gastric glands to secrete gastric juice. And secretin is the hormone secreted by inner lining of the duodenum, and it stimulates the production of pancreatic juice. The third one, that is the cholecystokinin, it stimulates release of bile from the gallbladder. So, this is the hormone that is being secreted by the digestive gland secretion. The main three are the gastrin, secretin and the CCK cholecystokinin. Next, the most important, that is the gonadal sex hormone. The sex hormone affect the growth, development, reproductive cycle and the sexual behavior. Whereas these sex hormones also being produced in a very little quantity by the adrenal gland. So, adrenal gland secretes small quantity of these hormones, but the testes of the male and the ovaries of the female are their principal source. So, mainly they are being secreted by the functional part is being secreted by the ovaries and the testes, but these are also a minute quantity secreted by the adrenal gland. These gonads produce and secrete three major category of the steroid hormone. These are the androgen, estrogen and progesterone. So, all these three types are found in both male and the female, but it is like significantly different proportion. One is being secreted by more in the female and more in the male. So, accordingly they are being in different proportion, but they are present in both. So, testes in the male, it possesses the two kind of cells, the sperm producing germinal cell and the hormone producing interstitial cells. The hormone is being produced by the interstitial cell. So, the hormone produced in the male is called the androgen, and of this the most important is the testosterone. So, testosterone, what is the function of it? Testosterone stimulates the development of the male character, during which the body at puberty start developing the facial hair and the voice cracks and the deepen into the male. While on the other hand, the ovary in the female produce two kind of hormone, estrogen and progesterone. So, estrogen is secreted from the follicle of the ovary and stimulate the development of breast and fat deposition in the hip of a mature woman. And estrogen, it prepares the wall of the uterus for receiving the fertilized egg. On the other hand, what the function of progesterone is to secrete by the corpus luteum. Corpus luteum, what is corpus luteum? It is the follicle left after the release of the ovum. So, it brings about the final change into the uterus for the retention and growth of the fetus during the pregnancy. So, the hormone, gonadal sex hormone, that is being secreted by the male and the female. So, male in which it is secreted in the testes and the female into the ovary. The next important gland its hormone is the pancreas. That is the pancreas, it is containing a special group of cells that is called islet of Langerhans, which consist the three kind of cells. Three kind of cells, that is made up of like alpha producing hormone glucagon, beta producing hormone insulin, and the gamma cells produce the hormone, that is the somatostatin. So, glucagon, what the function of the glucagon is that it stimulates the breakdown of glycogen to the glucose in the liver and lead to the rise in the blood sugar level. And insulin, it performs two principal tasks. It promotes the glucose utilization in the body cells and stimulate the deposition of extra glucose in the body as glycogen in the liver. So, both glucagon and insulin, they have the opposite functions. Then the third one, that is somatostatin, it is also called as the GHH, that is growth hormone inhibiting hormone, that is GHIH, inhibit the secretion of insulin as well as the glucagon. So, the function of these hormones like blood sugar regulation. So, if there is an over secretion of the insulin, it results into the low blood sugar, and if there is under secretion of the insulin, it causes the high blood sugar. So, due to this under secretion or over secretion, it is a very common disease that nowadays has happened, is called as the diabetes. So, it is causing this particular. So, under secretion, non secretion or under secretion of the insulin cause the diabetes mellitus. It is a disease in which mainly the person feel like higher glucose in the blood. They excrete a great deal of urine loaded with the sugar, and they feel thirsty because of the more loss of the water through too much urination, and they also lose their weight, and so they become weak, and sometimes the patient may even lose their eyesight. The second condition is over secretion of the insulin. It causes the hypoglycemia or low blood sugar level. In this, brain may enter in a state of coma if the level of the sugar in the blood become very low. So, this becomes very serious in a condition. So, endocrine system, these all are the exocrine glands, those are being secreted, number of the hormones. Now, if there are the hormones, they must be regulated. So, how the hormones are being regulated, there are the process, because if there is excess of hormone, that may also affect the body, and if there is a low level of the hormone, that may also affect the body. So, definitely the hormone regulation at a kind, it is very important. So, how the hormone is being regulated, it is by the two process. The first one is the positive feedback and the negative feedback. So, by these processes, the hormone is being regulated. The feedback mechanism, the first, that is the negative feedback, in which it acts like a thermostat at a home. So, what are the function of thermostat? Thermostat is like if the temperature of the rooms go down, then the thermostat on and it reaches or higher the temperature. Again, when the temperature reaches at the set point, then again the furnace is turned off. Same like that, the hormone function, when the hormone is being required by the body, it is being secreted out. And then when the level of the hormone reaches to the level whatever is required, the hormone secretion is stopped. So, like example, the blood sugar increases after the meal. So, the pancreas secrete insulin, which tells the body cells to take in the glucose, and once the blood sugar level reaches normal, the pancreas stop making the insulin. So, often used to maintain the homeostasis. So, it means the hormones, they are also controlling the homeostasis process. So, for this homeostasis process, there are the hormones, that one is upregulating the hormone and one is downregulating the hormone level. So, in this, the homeostasis is usually maintained by the two hormones who have the antagonistic effect. Each hormone does the opposite of the other. So, like if we take an example, if the blood pressure drops too low, the pituitary releases the ADH hormone. which causes the kidney to reabsorb more water. And if the blood pressure increases too much, it is too high, in that condition, the heart will release the ANH. So, will cause the kidney to reabsorb the less water. So, in both cases, the homeostasis is maintained. If the blood pressure high, then one hormone is released, and if blood pressure is low, then the other hormone is released to maintain the blood pressure. Then next is the positive feedback. Positive feedback mechanism control the event that can be out of control and do not require continuous adjustment. So, in this, this is the really it maintain the homeostasis, because homeostasis is maintained in a condition when there is something being irregular, but these are the controlled by the positive feedback. Those are out of control method, like if we take an example of the childbirth. So, oxytocin stimulate the enhance the labor contraction, and as the labor continues, more oxytocin is released, and after that intensifies the contraction until the baby is outside the birth canal. So, oxytocin production stops as the labor stops and the baby is outside. So, this kind of control is under the positive feedback control. This is known as the positive feedback mechanism. So, these are the number of the gland learners that today we had learned. It is containing the number of the gland in their hormones, like it is including the pituitary gland, it is including the hypothalamus, the pituitary that is containing the anterior pituitary and the posterior pituitary, thyroid gland, parathyroid gland, thymus, adrenal gland, adrenal cortex that is being divided into the adrenal cortex and the adrenal medulla, and it is also containing the gonad hormone that is being secreted by the male organ and the female part, and the pineal gland that is also important. It is secreting the melatonin that is controlling our rhythmic cycle. So, learners, this we had gone through to the number of the glands and their hormones and how the hormones is being regulated. We can also go through this particular video that is that can also be summarize you what happened into the gland and what are the number of the glands and how what are their secretions and how the control mechanism or what kind of disorder may happen due to the overproduction and the underproduction of the hormone. So, learners, in this particular topic, we had gone through the number of the what kind of the signaling are through which the hormone is secreted and it is reaches to the target organ. And also we had gone through to the number of the glands, those are being secreted, those are secreting the number of the hormones as well as the organs through which they are being secreted out. And we had also gone through to the number of the of what are the function of these hormones as well as what happened when there is a under and over secretion of these hormones and the kind of the disorders that may happen due to the over and under secretion of these hormones. So, I think learners, you might have learned something from this particular lecture, and thank you so much for your attention. Thank you.